Hey. Oh. Okay, thank you everyone for coming to my talk. I made this game, well, I'm still working on it, called Lily. It's a flower game about how humans convert childhood trauma into organic disease later in life, and how we should screen kids instead of waiting for people to grow up. And I will talk about the design process, the inspirations. I will show sketches and GIFs and work of other artists. And this is a tool I use. Maybe it's also helpful for you guys. These are like three pillars in the design process I always want to keep in balance. So the first one is autobiography. It's the fuel for your project. It's why you're making this. I always try to be very honest so other people can relate to the project. And it's also about the inspirations for your work. Another one is context. So this is all about research and the value of your project in society, the surface of your project. And the third one is your craft. This is all about the technical skills, making it work, and also focusing on what are you good at. These are the three things I always want to keep in balance, and I will show a little bit how I did that. So this is an artist that really inspires me a lot. It's Fuyuko Matsui. She's a Japanese artist, and I personally really like the contrast between these subtle, these beautiful images, but also this horror things. So I was inspired with that, and I wanted to do something with this kind of vibe. So I started sketching. These are two sketches. And I wanted to do something with really flowy images. So this is one of the first prototypes I created. So obviously this was a little dark and depressed, and I needed something to frame this more. So I did some research to other artists, and I came across Rachel Ruys and Jan van Huysum, the painters from the 17th century who used flowers to communicate ideas and feelings and thoughts. So I also wanted to create this flower of bouquet to tell this story. So I started sketching again. Here you can see some sketches. And then I came up with this, a lily, but it was kind of a deformed flower, and I still use the mechanic to move the roots of the flower. I needed more of a game feel into it, so I decided to make a 3D game. And also have more interaction with the leaves and the roots. But this was still not like a game. So I tried some more interaction here and here, as I was looking for more cause and effect. A little bit slow. So here I designed a system that whenever you put roots into a dead leaf, another one would come up, and when that one would fall down, another leaf. And so you were searching for different leaves, and at the same time, the flower would grow. And if you would stuck a root in the stem, then another leaf would come up. So here I was really looking to create this sort of system. And then I was getting a little lost what kind of idea I wanted to communicate. So I did some more research, and I came across this theory of Franz Rupert. And He talks about how when trauma happens, when it's an overwhelming experience, the personality splits up, and the personality cannot fully experience the trauma, so it splits up into survival parts and the healthy parts and the traumatized parts. So I took this and I wanted to make three flowers of it. So the left one is are the survival parts, the middle were the healthy parts, and the right one were the trauma parts. And my idea was that you would constantly switch between the scenes and make the healthy flower grow and the surviving parts disappear. So that's what I tried. This is the survival flower, so to speak. And it's sticking its roots in itself, basically. And this scene, I created the healthy flower, so this one had water you could collect, and then it could freely, unlimitedly grow. So this would symbolize the healthy part. And in this scene, I created the trauma part. So this was like a sort of hard flower. And if you would move the vessels, the blood would flow. And then there was a technical problem. So not conceptual or story-wise. It would take a lot of time to load the scene. So I decided to put the three flowers together and just see what happens. And that's what I did here. And then I saw this human body in these three flowers, and I thought, well, maybe this is like a good direction to go after. So I designed the three, put the three models together, designed them a little bit better, so they were more clear what it would represent. And I also again tried to design some mechanics. So again, sticking roots into the flower itself, but it didn't really work out. And then I just experimented with mechanics. So this is a little accident, but it worked. I put three big leaves around the flower to open them up. And that, which led me to the mechanic of unfolding leaves. And I thought it was really mysterious and interesting, and also would connect to the vibe of the whole game. So I was going for that, but I didn't really, it had no like context. So I did some more research, and I really liked these paintings of the 17th century again. This is from Rembrandt van Rijn. And doctors in that time were dissecting people not for medical purposes or to understand the cause of death, but simply out of curiosity. And in the Netherlands, dissections were free and open to everyone, compared to the artists in the South that were painting a lot of pictures from the Bible or from Jesus Christ. So like the logic I took from these paintings and from these Dutch old masters was that to portray human organs simply means to look objectively at truth. And that really helped me because, you know, like making a game about childhood trauma can sometimes be a little overwhelming. These masters inspired me, and I learned from them again. And I took this this interest in science a little bit further, and I came across the adverse childhood experience study. This is a study that was done in 1996 across 17,000 people. And they asked these people, which one of these childhood traumas have you experienced? And for every yes, they would get 1 point. So emotional abuse, physical, sexual abuse, household challenges, and neglect. And then they would measure the ACE score. And they also measured their current health later in life, and they found out that the more childhood trauma you experienced, the higher risk was for high risk behaviors and diseases. And they also found out that one out of eight people has four or more of these childhood trauma. So that was a huge discovery. And I really wanted to do something with that, because that's this science, doctors started to create treatment protocols to screen kids, because it's not efficient to wait for people to get sick. So I took this scientific medical vibe. I wanted to put that in my game. So here you can see the colors are a lot different. And I wanted to take that more further, and I put those statistics in this game. And here you can see the spheres. I wanted to symbolize those diseases by little insects. But I guess the vibe was not really, was too medical, so I brought it a little bit more back. And here on the left and the right, you can see that I was really trying to communicate this design idea. And in the next scene, I also wanted to make more of a gaming feel, and this was really, really bad. You would have this logbook, and then you could see what you have discovered, which would basically communicate, find all the diseases, which is not so good. So I skipped that as well, and now I am here. I'm still working on it. So I got this animation. I hope I showed you how the design process is full of mistakes and failures, and that you constantly need to learn and reflect. And these three, this tool really helps me, so maybe it can help you as well. I think your work can bring quality if you're being really honest and open about it, but at the same time, you have to be careful that you don't become too inward, so no one understands what you're doing. And also the context is really useful to think about what kind of theme and concept your work has in society, so you can build bridges towards other disciplines or companies or brands, but at the same time, don't focus too much on the research, and also focus on the craft, on your skill sets. I think that will bring you an original style that stands out from the rest of all the indie games. But also avoid trying to make too much of a game, because I kind of feel that. I hope this is useful for you, and thank you very much for listening.